My name is Camilla Luihn, and I work as a metal and jewelry artist based in Oslo. And I work here in Kirkerisen, the bazaars in the center of Oslo, and also as an assistant professor at the Oslo Academy of the Arts. I have been working now, I think, around 30 years as a solo artist, and I always work project-based. I make my themes for myself or projects that I want to do, and then I adapt the materials and techniques into that theme. I think many people think that I have a broad sort of technical and material variety, but this is something that I grew up with. My mother, she used to do everything. So for me, it was, it's natural to explore everything and to find everything interesting. So that's what I do. But lately, I think it was in 2015, I started working with enamels. And it was like a very passionate relationship. And I've been working with that since, actually, and doing a lot of research with enamels. Well, I usually use an array of different colors, and these are opaque and transparent enamels for sifting and for a technique that we call wet packing. And I used a lot of them when I was making. I made a year ago a mayor chain for the new Moss municipality. And then I used very much a technique called cloisonné, and another one, champlevé. I made this color chart with the colors I used. And so these are different opaque colors, just to test them and see how they were working together. And then I've been lately working a lot with liquid enamels. You can mix them with water and they become sort of liquid, and you can paint and you can dip or you can pour. And it's quite painterly, so I really enjoy working with them lately. And this is enamels that I've been, doing this with this process. But I tend to try out every type of technique, and I think all enamels are interesting. So it's just a matter of what type of project I'm working on at all times. At the Oslo National Academy of Arts, I have been working there since 2019. And I was extremely happy to get the position there. It was it's like a dream come true, because I love teaching and communicating, and I have a very strong sense of responsibility for the newly established artists. And now I'm working on establishing re-establishing, I would say, the enameling workshop at school. And it's a passion of mine. Since I started with enameling myself, I started to read about the historic use of enameling in Norway. And it's very sad that it's a practice that has died out in Norway. But after I started re-establishing the workshop at the KIO, a lot of artists have approached and wants to learn from me. So it's been quite a good experience, actually, and I'm willing to give away. I want everybody to start enameling. So. I'm very excited to share my knowledge and research, actually, yeah. Recently, I've been working with pieces inspired by the pandemic, and I started last summer working with wood, like worry beads. You know, in Catholic society, you have these strings of beads when you may say prayers. And I made three large worry beads, and I was trying to make them as huge as I could do. And now I've been working on some pictures in enamel, and they are a little bit in family with Kjartan Slettmark's Nixon enamels. So these are pandemic enamels. And I don't know how many they will be, but I tend to work through, you know, like thought processes. So we'll see how many they will become. Yeah. Right now I'm working on an exhibition at the Kunstnerforbundet in Oslo, a solo exhibition, and it's this fall, so most of what I'm doing now is concentrated about that exhibition. And then I'm also going to have a solo exhibition at Four in Gothenburg in 2022, and an exhibition at Fruits Gallery in China, and also in 2022, and in Baltimore Jewelry Center with the artist group ARKIVET. So it's a lot of things to do. I love to work all the time, so I spend all my free time working on art, and it's I don't know, it feels like it's becoming more and more an important part of my life, and I want to spend all my time in the studio or at Kio and just work and create and think. I tend to find inspiration in my surroundings, in nature, in people, in events, and also political events. I think that's how I live through it. I have to think it through art and sort of reflect upon it and analyze. It's not necessarily something that I'm very aware of while I'm working, but when I see what I've been doing, it's very clear to me that this is something that touches upon at least the times we're living in. I moved here in 2019 when I got the opportunity to rent from Oslo municipality, and they have some studios here in Kirkristen. With perhaps 10 to 15 artists working. Before the artists moved here in the 70s, it was built actually as in 1859 as butcher's sales shops. And I have done just changes to make it more like my space and to create the gallery space. PORTABEL is something I've been thinking about for years because in Norway we don't have any exhibition spaces mainly for art jewellery. And I think that's very important that there's spaces and places that established artists or freshly educated artists can show their work. I initiated an artist group called ARKIVET, and it's four or five mainly jewelry artists working together in theme-based productions, and we also invite external artists working in other fields like video, photo, writing, and it was a little bit hard to start up. But as soon as we got some exhibitions, the ball started rolling, and now we have been exhibiting in Athens, in Munich, in Finland, and we are having an exhibition in 2022 in Baltimore Jewelry Center, And it's been quite good for us because we force ourselves to make projects that we all agree upon, and then we tend to use each other's strengths, like to collaborate. So it's quite interesting to have that community. Yeah, I think art jewelry is the ultimate art in public spaces, because you bring with you the jewelry and you start conversation and a dialogue anywhere.